One of the greatest fears in American nutrition today is bread. The idea is that bread can make you fat and it's liable to kill you, but what does the research actually say? Does it actually make you fat or does it actually cause you to lose weight? I'm gonna look at the research, even if you've lost weight on it, hear me out and find out why many people lose weight getting rid of bread, getting rid of gluten, but we're gonna look at the actual research here. Hey everybody, Chad Kruiser here with Health and Homestead. If you end up liking this video, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, the bell notifications, and share a comment below, but hear me out, because I know some of you are gonna struggle to hear, but we're gonna look at the research. So what does it say? Let's start off by looking at the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition. So this was a study that was conducted looking at 16 overweight college-age men, and they split them up into two different groups. Group A had to eat 12 slices of white bread with a total of 1 gram of fiber in all these together. And group B had to eat 12 slices of enriched fiber bread that ended up having a total of 25.5 grams. Now, what was the result? The average calories before the intervention was 3,200 per day per person. And someone might be thinking, well, that's quite a bit of calories. It is. And these were overweight people, so they consumed quite a bit of calories. But Americans in general do consume quite a bit of calories. You can actually look around the world and see the average calorie consumption per capita, and Americans are quite high. But these weren't just any Americans, they were college-age students going on this diet, and they were given a total of 3,200 calories per day, but they had to eat 4 slices of bread per meal, and they could eat as much as they wanted. They weren't forced to eat the 3,200 calories. What was the result? Group A lowered their caloric intake from 3,200 to 2,350 calories, and group B lowered their caloric intake from 3,200 to 1,975 calories. Eating this way actually lowered the amount of food that they ate because they had consumed so much bread that it lowered the calories total. Group A lost on average 13.72 pounds on, you know, 12 slices of white bread, or 6.26 kilograms. And group B lost an average of 19.14 pounds or 8.77 kilograms. So what on earth is happening? We're going to go a little further into the research in this particular study, but these overweight guys go on a diet and they're given as much food as they normally eat in a day. The only catch is they have to eat 4 slices of either like junky white bread or some kind of fiber-enriched bread, and they have to eat at least 4 pieces at every meal. And what it actually did, we're going to find out, it caused them to lose quite a bit of weight. This is actually an amazing study, but it doesn't end there. Group A's cholesterol dropped from 235 to 155, and group B's cholesterol dropped from 224 to 172, and there was no change in their fasting glucose. It's interesting that one of these groups ended up getting their cholesterol down to almost 150. And by the way, when people get their cholesterol under 150, they're in nearly a heart attack free zone. Now, nobody under 150 will get a heart attack, but very, very, very few. Like in the Alameda County Health Study, they didn't find anybody that had a heart attack under 150. Now, there have been people who have heart attacks with cholesterol under 150, but it's very rare. It's very unlikely. And so this bread helped them get down to a very, very healthy, at least in one of the groups, cholesterol. This is actually quite amazing. But what this did, eating all of this bread, even the junky white bread, and by the way, I'm not here to promote junk white bread. To me, I'm on a whole food diet. So I eat whole foods, non-refined foods, and so I'm not here to promote white bread. But fascinatingly enough, if you eat 12 slices of bread and you're overweight, chances are you're gonna lose weight. And that's what the research actually shows. But people say, but Chad, when I went off of bread, I lost weight. True. These guys, when they went on a bunch of bread, they lost weight. And you say, but what about the people who stop eating it and lose weight? There's a reason both ways. Now, number one, the bread caused these guys to eat less calories because the bread was so filling that it just filled up space. Your stomach has stretch receptors, and once you hit just a certain size, your stomach is like, that's enough, stop, I've had enough. Now, so these guys lost weight eating bread. So there's really very little evidence that bread itself is causing weight gain in people at all. But you say, but what about the people who stop eating bread and, well, they lose weight? That's proof right there, isn't it? Not necessarily. Do people typically eat 12 slices of bread in a day and nothing else? No, they put things on bread. What do they put? Do they typically put plain fruit? Well, not often. Some people do, but typically they put refined junk foods, like they'll put a bunch of refined sugar junk on their bread, or they'll put a bunch of, even peanut butter is very calorically dense, and then they blame the bread for the weight gain, or they put on it meat, which is calorically dense, and then they blame the bread for the weight gain, or, you know, they put cheese on it, which is very calorically dense, and they blame the bread for the weight gain. But that doesn't answer the question of why, when they stop eating bread, do they end up losing weight? Because when you stop eating bread, what do you stop eating? You're thinking bread. No, you don't just stop eating bread, historically anyway. Now there's all kinds of, you can buy now gluten-free junk food. Historically, if you went gluten-free, what did you eat? You ate whole healthy foods and grains that didn't have gluten in them. You know, those can be any kind of grain that doesn't have gluten, but you typically stopped eating almost all junk food that is in the grocery store because most junk food has wheat in it. And so you can't eat things like most cookies historically. I know now you can make gluten-free cookies, you can buy gluten-free cookies, but historically you couldn't buy almost any junk food because it had some wheat in it. So if you stop eating junk food, just guess what's gonna happen to your weight. Yeah, you'll lose weight, right? So one of the key factors is, and so people think it was the bread, and they don't think about what they put on the bread, right? You put your bologna on your bread, and you blame the bread for the weight gain. And so is it the bread? No, because when we actually add a bunch of bread, I mean, most people aren't eating 12 slices of bread in a day, but yet if you add that to someone's diet and say, the only factor you have to change is add 12 slices of bread. In this case, it was even junk food bread helped people to lose weight because it's just not as calorically dense as some of the other things out there like cheese and you know, meat or various other things that are out there, even potato chips and so forth, because all that oil are just super calorically dense. So this is one of the factors. People can't eat junk food, so they lose weight. I want to be very clear. If you are one of the 6% of people, according to the top researcher on gluten, Alessio Fasano, he shares with us that roughly 6% of people have a reaction to either wheat or gluten. So you have 1% of people who have celiac disease, and you have somewhere around 5% of people who have either some kind of intolerance or some kind of allergy, some kind of reaction. So you're talking 6% of people do have trouble with either wheat or gluten. And by the way, if you're one of those people, avoid it. I'm totally with you there. If somebody's allergic to something or has an autoimmune response to a certain food or substance, just avoid it. But 94% of people do perfectly fine with it. So if you're one of those people and you notice you feel better, go for it. But I think many times, once again, the reason people feel better when they switch over to a gluten-free diet is because they stop eating so much junk food. But when it comes to celiac disease, that is a clear autoimmune reaction, and there are certain people who are just sensitive to it. So if you're one of those in the 6% group, simply avoid it. What about the rest of society? Does it promote things like cancer, heart disease? Let's see what the research actually says. This is from the journal Circulation, and this is whole grain intake and mortality from all causes, cardiovascular disease and cancer. And notice the conclusions. Our meta-analysis demonstrated inverse associations of whole grain intake with total and cause-specific mortality, and findings were particularly strong and robust for cardiovascular disease. But once again, I want to go to even a little further. You might be saying, but I've seen these folks that they're promoting these charts, and they show that from the 1970s, we have started eating way more grain since then, and people have gotten fatter. And it's true. People have eaten more grain since the 1970s, but notice they only start the chart back in the 1970s. Let's go even further back in time. I want to go back even further. So let's go back in history and look at BMI, Body Mass Index of Americans from 1870 to 2013. Notice back in 1870, the average American, their body mass index was 22 point something. They were thin, trim. Anything 25 and above is considered overweight. And so until just around the year 1925, the average American was, you know, a healthy weight. After that time, the average American began to be overweight. And then back in the 70s, you noticed that people really significantly shot out of a cannon when it came to weight. Now, when we look at things like this, like flour and cereal,
potato and sweet potato consumption, these are what people would call carbohydrates. And people say, well, you know, maybe it's all those carbs they're eating. Maybe they're just eating more grains, and that's the reason we've gotten so large today. But let's actually look at the history. So notice what we see here. Here we are in 1909. How many pounds of flour and cereal did the average American consume in 1909, over 100 years ago? They averaged 300 pounds per year, per person. And now they eat somewhere around 200. So we're eating 100 pounds less of grains, or, you know, at least flour per year compared to what we used to. Now, are we bigger or smaller than we were in 1909? Remember, the average American back in 1909 was fit. Today, it is abnormal to be fit. Actually, the vast majority of Americans, somewhere around 70% of people, are overweight, and we eat 100 pounds less of grains a year. So is it the grains that have made us larger? Obviously, that is not the causative factor here. But let's go even further. Here's potatoes. You think, oh, maybe it's the potatoes making people fat. Notice 100 years ago, over 100 years ago, your average American ate around 200 pounds of potatoes, and now we eat somewhere around maybe, you know, 125. So 75 pounds less. And when it comes to sweet potatoes, maybe they used to eat at that time somewhere maybe 30 pounds, and we're down to hardly any at all. So looking at these factors, some of the main things like potatoes and grains, we're eating significantly less. So these things are what people are afraid of. Don't eat the potatoes, don't eat the grains, they'll make you fat. And when Americans ate way more of these things, we were significantly thinner. So this is not any at all. Now, Americans are consuming more calories today. I have a whole seminar talking about that in a seminar called The Gut-Brain Connection. You can check it out in the links below. But here's the thing. So in reality, yes, we have gotten larger. There's many factors. Much of it, to be honest with you, is just refined junk food. That's one of the very key factors. We're also eating way more cheese and higher amounts of things like chicken that has gotten way fatter, like three times as fat today as it was 100 years ago. So times have changed in the American food chain. Foods are very different than they used to be, and the foods that we are consuming are very different than they used to be. But it's clearly not grains. You say, but Chad, you didn't hit on the fact that carbs turn into fat. That is a half truth. Actually, it's not even a half truth. It's a small portion of a truth, because it's true that a small amount of carbohydrates that you eat, a fraction of the carbohydrates that you eat actually transfer into fat. The vast majority of them actually don't. And so this whole thing is really kind of it's just a partial truth. But we can clearly see that when Americans ate massive quantities of grains, potatoes, sweet potatoes, that they were significantly thinner. And if you add 12 servings a day, overweight people actually, in this study, actually lost weight. So if you agree, share something below. If you don't, I would love to hear what you say below. Either way, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, hit the bell notifications as you subscribe. You don't want to miss out on our upcoming videos, and check out our links below. God bless and have a fantastic day.